Hello and welcome to St Michael-in-the-Hamlet Church here in the centre of Liverpool on this Easter Sunday 2021. It's great to have you with us. Welcome to you from wherever you may be watching, whether it's here in Liverpool or further afield. It's just wonderful to have you worshipping with us this morning. Hallelujah! Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah! 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 This is the day when our Lord Jesus Christ passed from death to life. Throughout the world, Christians celebrate the awesome power of God. As we hear his word and proclaim all that God has done, we can be confident that we shall share his victory over death and live with him forever. You may have brought a candle with you, have one close to hand, but you may not have one immediately close to hand, so you might like to just turn off the video and find yourself a candle and then turn it back on again. So together, as a church near and far, we light our Easter candles. May the light of Christ, rising in glory, banish all darkness from our hearts and our minds. We sing together in our hearts, in our living rooms, in our homes. Our first hymn, See What a Morning, Gloriously Bright.
With light as the air.
Let's turn from our sins and ask Jesus to forgive us as we pray together. Lord, we love the joy of Easter Sunday, but we may not have walked through Holy Week. We may not have been humbled by Jesus' hands washing our feet. We may not have tasted the bread and wine of his last shared meal. We may not have known the primal fear of Gethsemane or the bewilderment of the disciples at his betrayal. We may not have known the way of sorrow to Golgotha. The blood, sweat, and tears of a crown of thorns, and the weight of a cross that will bear our dying body. Therefore, Lord, we confess our failure to feel one with Jesus in his dying as well as in his resurrection life. As we celebrate our risen Lord, we remember the man of sorrows who died for our sins, and we bow our heads in penitence. Amen. Lord, in the warmth of your hands washing human feet, we are forgiven. Lord, in your willingness to drink the cup of suffering for us, we are forgiven. Lord, in the wide embrace of your arms upon the cross, we are forgiven. Risen Lord, in your emerging from the tomb, death is defeated, we are forgiven. Hallelujah. Amen. Our reading this morning is taken from John chapter 20, verses 1 to 18.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but did not go in. Then Peter, Simon, came following him and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and he believed. As for yet, they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. Jesus appears to Mary Magdalene. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting there where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabuni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her.
A year or so ago, I was at a school reunion. It's the first time I'd seen some of these lads for nearly 40 years. I was standing at the bar, talking about what I do, the fact I'm a vicar, when one old friend said, "What makes a Christian then?" To which another friend quite surprisingly answered, before I could get in there with an answer, answered with this response: belief in the resurrection. That's what makes a Christian. Belief in the resurrection. And he was right. Easter, not Christmas, is the major festival in the church calendar. The high point of the liturgical year. Without the resurrection, the Christian faith is simply incomplete. Bishop David Jenkins, then the Bishop of Durham, was misquoted in the 1980s when it was reported that he had said that the resurrection is merely a conjuring trick with bones. That's not what he said, actually. What he said was this: the resurrection is more than a conjuring trick with bones. More. Much more. Jesus is raised up from the dead. Jesus wasn't a zombie, as we see in the ever-popular movies and TV series. He wasn't like the living dead. Jesus was dead, he was buried, and then 3 days later, he reappeared. He was alive. Fully alive. He is alive. Fully alive. His resurrected appearance was witnessed by, firstly, by Mary Magdalene, then by the apostles, then by the two disciples on the Emmaus Road, and also in excess of 500 different people. Jesus appeared both as he was in human form, yet also transformed. He wasn't immediately recognizable. Mary didn't recognize him. She thought he was the gardener. The two men on the road to Emmaus only recognized him in the breaking of bread. However, his resurrection body had a physicality to it. He could touch and be touched. Thomas put his hands in the holes in Jesus' hands. The resurrected Jesus cooked and ate food with his disciples on the Galilean beach. Yet, unlike our temporal human bodily condition, the resurrected Jesus was able to transcend our time, space, limitations. He could materialize and dematerialize at will. Oh, what a mystery, meekness and majesty, the man who is God. The resurrection, it is a glorious mystery, Mystery of mysteries. We can never fully understand it, this side of the veil. Yet we believe it. Some of us have experienced its power firsthand. And we live in the hope of its promise, that we too will be raised up on the last day, when dust and ashes will have no more dominion, and we will receive a resurrection body just like our Saviour, Jesus, the firstborn of the dead. Hallelujah. 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 He is risen. He is risen indeed. Amen. We declare our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us sing in our hearts, in our homes, the hymn In Christ Alone.
Here in the love of Christ, I stand.
we bow our heads for our community prayers.
Alleluia, he is risen. Jesus, our way, our truth, our life, be with us and all who follow you. Deepen our appreciation of your truth and fill us with your life, Jesus, Lord of life. God of promise and God of hope, who through your great mercy have granted us new birth through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, we praise your wonderful name, God of glory, God of might, who through your great power have granted us new strength to endure all things through faith in Christ our risen King. We praise your wonderful name. Amen. Thank you, Father, for the empty tomb. Teach us to wonder at his presence and rejoice in its reality. Help us to speak out boldly as Mary Magdalene did, and never be ashamed of proclaiming your good news in Jesus' name. Dear Father, we pray for all who are sick at this time, for those who are lonely or sad, and for those who are grieving. Be with them, Lord. We continue to pray for John and Emma. Hope they continue to improve each day. Remembering also Dave, hoping he will soon be feeling better. Be with all those who need our prayers, Lord. Amen. May the light of Jesus shine continually to drive away all darkness. May Christ, the morning star who knows no setting, find his light ever burning in our hearts. He who gives light to all creation and who lives and reigns for ever and ever. Amen. God gave us eyes to see the beauty of spring and wonder at every living thing, every new leaf, every budding flower, every new baby we see. He gave us ears to hear from the springtime song of birds to our favourite music, to hear the sound of children's voices and their laughter. We look forward to being able to meet again with our families and friends and share the joy of family time once again. God has us in his care. God made you and God made me. He made the world for us all to see. God loves you, and long ago he sent his Son to tell us so. Jesus showed us many things to love and share, and dance and sing, to learn and pray, to help and care. He promised he'd always be there. He died but then came back to life. Let's celebrate, for he is alive. Amen. I wish you all a very happy Easter. Amen.
You may be on your own, you may be gathered together with some other folk, but we're going to share the peace together. And if you're with other people, you may like to shake their hands or hug them. But if you're not, you might just like to wave. And imagine that you're waving to your friends from St Michael's Church and to Christians all over the world. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us share with one another a sign of peace. And so we collect together our words and prayers, saying together, Lord Jesus, thank you for promising to be with us always. Help us to remember that promise when we don't feel brave enough to be your disciples. Help us to remember that the first people to know that you rose from the tomb were ordinary people like us, women and men who didn't feel very brave. Give us courage to believe and to tell others, as Mary did, this Easter and always. Amen. So for our blessing today, we receive a blessing by listening to a sung blessing sung to us by churches from all across the nation. Have a very happy and joyful Easter day.
Manna rain down from heaven. This isn't second guessing. We know that we are protected. May the peace that surpasses all understanding be our message. Grace and favors in your nature, in your essence.
May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations,
and your family, and your children,
and the children, and the children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations. Children, and the children, may his presence go before you, and behind you, and beside you.
Hello. Over recent months, we have done our best to keep you informed of the financial challenge we are facing to bridge our income gap, sustain our buildings and clergy, as well as our mission and ministry within the local community. Little did we know when we began this process, which we have called stepping up to the plate, of the further challenge we would be faced with due to COVID-19. As our church buildings have been closed for the past few months, we have lost regular rental income from the church hall in Belgrave Road, as well as collections from our church services. The work of our church is reliant on people's generosity. We do not receive anything in the way of funds from the diocese. If you feel that you are in a position to help, there are many ways you can do so. Some people give through the parish giving scheme. One can also give through by direct debit or a one-off payment. Details of how you can do this will be on the following slide. Thank you so much for your generosity and your support of the church in so many different ways. God bless you.